So we're here on Thorah Island. We're in the bee yard. It's a beautiful day and a beautiful location. We're all very happy to be here. I'd like to explain a little bit about why we bring our bees here and what the whole Buckfast process is. We've brought many mating nucleus colonies over with us today. We brought them from an adjacent island, Georgina Island, to Thorah Island, and we have different drone lines on each of those islands. The drone line that we have on this island is very well established, and they're very, very gentle colonies. They have a low tendency to swarm, and they're quite productive. So we're really happy with this drone line. I want to give a little shout out to Paul Montaux, who the late great Paul Montaux, who worked together with us Buckfast Breeding. He managed this island for quite a number of years, and we're carrying things on, and the drone line that we're using now, a lot of that comes from his efforts. So we have gentle bees, and the gentle behavior is passed from the male side when you're breeding bees. So if you have gentle colonies producing the males that your queens are going to be mating with, that will be passed on. On the flip side, on the female side, the hygienic behavior, keeping the hive clean, doing things that help prevent diseases, that's inherited from the female side. So we're trying to do both of those things here on the island. We have full-size colonies that provide the drones that we want, and then we bring these mini mating nucleus colonies that you saw us handling from the truck to the boat to the truck and out. Now we've spread them around here and open them up and let those fly. Very soon we're going to go through and harvest these queens and take them back so that we can requeen colonies on the mainland. I'd like to introduce a couple people here that help us out. This is Laurie Simard. Laurie,
hi, Paul.
Hey, Laurie. Laurie is our boat captain. She gets us out here to the island, and we obviously can't do things on the island without that transportation. And she volunteers to assist us with our bee work while we're out here on the island. She's got some of her own beehives. She's getting going with them. And I'm just going to ask Laurie a couple questions about the history of the island. It's a great spot for bees. Can you tell us a little bit about the history of the island?
Okay. In the late or mid-1800s, this island was used by the Chippewa Native Indians of Georgina as a fishing stopover. And then some people came over from Britain and ended up on this island. There's three founding families on this island, the Whites, the Davidsons, and the Warrens. And my cousin Margie, who's a volunteer with us as well, and myself, we share our great-grandfather. He's from the island. So they settled on this island and they farmed on the island. They had sheep, they had beef, and I think there was even some dairy cattle on the island. It was a pretty harsh way of life. You got to consider in the winter coming over with a horse and cutter over to the island on the ice. There was many mishaps, but they farmed here and this was their home. And now over the generations, those families have remained on the island, but we also have other cottages. There's 50 other cottages. And so we have people from the States that were founding from the States that use this as a fishing camp, and they all have cottages on the island. So it's an island where once you get here, you want to stay here. So we have a lot of fourth and fifth generation people on the island. It's a perfect place for bees, and you know, we enjoy volunteering, and I've been a volunteer for about 5 years, and I guess that's back to you. Don't know what else you want to know.
Well, because it was farmed, the land was cleared, and it's not farmed anymore, so bee plants have grown up voluntarily. We have sumac, we have sweet clover, many, many other plants grow in this kind of environment. And because they do well foraging, the colonies thrive, and that's really important when we're trying to do this breeding work. We don't want to have hives that are struggling to keep going, or they're not producing enough drones, and they have to be really thriving to produce the quantity of drones that we need for mating. I'm going to introduce somebody else here. This is Rachel Bryans, and she works with Monroe Honey. And Monroe Honey is another Buckfast breeder that we collaborate with. We actually provide a stud service for Monroe Honey. So they bring their nukes out here, and those nukes, the queens and those nukes get to mate with our queens. Rachel, what do you do with those queens?
Once we collect those queens, Paul, we take them home and we test them further for hygienic behavior. And we'll raise our own queens from those and sell them to the beekeepers of Ontario.
Huh. How many queens a year would you produce?
I would say about 3,000 queens.
Is that right? Wow, that's a lot of queens. And who do you sell them to?
Just basically all the beekeepers, hobbyists, commercial beekeepers of Ontario.
So they're really getting spread throughout the province then?
Yes. Yeah.
That's great. How many mating nucleus colonies do you have to produce that many queens?
We have 1,000.
1,000. Wow, that's great. Well, you must have a lot of great people working with you to get
we
all
do.
That done.
That's right.
Yeah, that's good. Thanks, Rachel. So we're going to move on now and get some work done here. Dave's going to start. He's going to open up a hive and show you how nice these bees are, and how we're able to use those colonies to produce the genetics that we want. So Dave, you'll open up a hive now.
Okay, so here we have kind of one of our full-size strong hives here up on Thorah Island. So we're just kind of going to show you what the kind of bees are like around here and how we breed them. And this is kind of the end result. So all the super, they're actually real productive bees this year. All the supers we put on them previously are already jam-packed full of honey. And they kind of stay as a nice full-size colony. Nice and strong because they really have that low tendency to swarm. We keep the wraps on here all winter long and into the spring. We tend to not get up here too early. And none of the colonies have swarmed this year. They really have that kind of bred in them. But the other thing you can kind of see is as we lift off this inner cover, just how gentle these bees are. So again, we haven't used any smoke on these bees yet. And when we're actually working up here, we don't use any smoke. So real gentle bees. And you can see just as I wave my hand over this colony, none of them are even jumping up to kind of see my hand. And that's kind of an invitation to attack, waving your hand kind of sharply over top of the colony. So real calm bees. They really, again, you can kind of notice we're now into their kind of space and we've vibrated the colony around by taking things off and this and that. But still, it doesn't really bother them. They're real nice kind of gentle bees, moving around slowly and not attacking my hand at all. So these are the bees of Thorah Island.
Now we're looking through the mini nukes to cage these queens, find them, see if they're laying eggs, and cage the queens. We divide it up into where we have finders and markers, cagers. So how are you guys doing? Are you finding some queens?
Yep.
All right. This one's done. The lid's turned upside down. It's ready for a cell. The other two in the progress of looking through for queens. Yeah. We just want to see how to open up these nukes. There is some technique that really helps to be able to use them. It's taken a little while to learn that, but Dave's going to open this up and show us. So he's take up the lid, turn it upside down, then turn the box away from him so the frames are in a more comfortable position. He'll pry out the cell, have a look at it. That cell has been hatched. We can see it's been chewed out at the end here. And they're in the process of starting to break that cell down. So they're removing that. So we take that out. That helps us give us an idea whether there is a queen in this colony or not. Looks good so far. So then Dave's going to pry the frames. We don't pry against the styrofoam. We pry against the frame. The styrofoam boxes aren't very strong, so we do it that way. And then we take out the frame closest to the feeder first. The queen's most likely to be on that frame. We'll have a look on one side, look on the other side. There's cap brood. You see eggs, Dave?
Yep.
Great. So, game's on. It looks good. He's going to set that frame down on the lid just to get it out of the way. Sometimes the queens get over onto the boxes, and it's helpful if the frames are all out of the way if the queen is in on the box itself. You get through quickly and look for the queen. You'll find her on the frame. So, speed is very helpful here. So that's three frames out. Okay,
she's
on the box. That's great. Now we know that the queen's there. And Dave passes that on to me, and we'll mark that queen coming right up here. So we've got the queen in between her fingers here. You can hold her top and bottom or side to side as long as it's on the thorax. Thorax is quite tough and they can take a little bit of handling. We get that queen positioned as high as possible in our fingers, and then we brace our hand against the other hand so that we can mark in a very controlled way. Draw a nice little circle on there. And this here is white, so we've got a white mark on. Close the lid of the paint up quickly so it doesn't dry out. And then we lift the right wing, since it's an even year, and clip it right where the inside of the wing changes directions. There's an angle there. So she's marked and clipped and ready for a cage. So here we are back, putting the queen in the cage, do a little back flip, and in she goes. So we've got her queen. Now we'll put in the attendants. So we'll take a frame from that colony that the queen came from and take some of the bees that she's been living with and transfer them in. We put five worker bees in, and we try to pick the youngest looking bees possible. If we get stung putting in one of these bees, that bee will die and she can't take care of the queen. So we're very careful how we put them in so that they don't die. There she is. Now we need to put in a candy tube. There's the tube with the candy. And we just push that in the hole here part way. And that gives her food to eat for the next week, as much as a week. But we try to introduce her as quickly as possible. The acceptance of the queens is better if they've been freshly caught and introduced into a new colony. After harvesting the queens, the next step is to requeen the colony by giving them a queen cell. So as you can see, we've marked the colony that's done, that's ready for cell, by turning the lid upside down. Lori's going to take that lid off, and Dave will come along with the cell. We've got the incubator in the shade. He makes sure there's space for that cell to go in and puts it in a way that it's going to hang well on the frames. And then Brooke's going to pour some sugar syrup in. She pours it nice and slow. If there's any bees in there, that gives them an opportunity to run up and get out of the way. And we'll fill it right up. Let's do a little bit more, Brooke. It's very dry up here and they really need the feed. Excellent, great. And now Lori can put the lid back on. And as we've said in some of our other videos, we put that lid down tight. That's important. Keeps the queen from getting into that feeder. We don't want her drowning in there. And then we just repeat the process for all of these nukes that you see out here. And come back in 2 weeks, harvest some more queens. Do this 5 times this summer, and things can't get much better than that. So I hope you've enjoyed learning a bit more about our Buckfast breeding program on Thorah Island. We hope we're doing Brother Adam of Buckfast Abbey, the originator of this strain of bees, doing his name good service here. We're very proud of our queens, and we'll get right home and get this one into a colony right away. Thanks a lot for watching. See you another time. So look at all those beautiful Buckfast bees. We're taking them home, giving them a good home. Had a great day up on the island. Things have worked out well. So what do you say, everybody?
Bees!